Hi, I'm Jim Booker with HorizonHobby.com. You know, the ParkZone warbirds have just been phenomenal airplanes for most modelers. They're easy to fly, aerobatic, durable. I mean, if you happen to, get a little too low in that inverted low pass at the flying field and scratch up something, they're easy to repair. Or if you have to replace a part, just grab another one, bolt it on. So, we've all had a great time with all these warbirds, and today I've got Matt Andren with me, and he's going to talk about a new airplane from ParkZone. But wait, it's not a warbird. Matt, come on, what's up with this?
Well, wanted to do something a little different. As you mentioned, the past couple of years at CEF, we've debuted a new warbird. The first year was the T-28, then the Corsair. Last year we debuted the P-51BL. And, so a lot of people were expecting a warbird this year, so we thought we'd mix it up a little bit and give them something completely different. Here we have the new ParkZone X-300. It's your typical ParkZone construction, all Z foam. Comes out of the box as a bind and fly and a plug and play, just like all the rest of the warbirds. I mean, it's the same level of completion you've come to expect from ParkZone warbirds, but now in an aerobatic airplane.
Yeah, well, of course, the X-300 is well known for having great aerobatic capabilities. But
absolutely.
I've heard rumors this thing's got a number of things that are a bit different than what we've been seeing from ParkZone, and
I can
see this very cool color scheme. There's no doubt about that.
Very bright, very easy to see in the sky. No problems there.
So, let's start at the front and go back. It's got a different propeller on it.
Yes, basically the power system has been completely updated on this airplane to give a lot of power. Truthfully, it's got a 15 size motor. It will be it's a metal can motor. New prop comes with the traditional 30 amp speed control, and then we'll also have a 2225C battery.
Oh, 25C, okay. So it'll real secret to performance.
Yeah, so it'll have be able to handle the current that this airplane demands.
Now, you say 15, is that the same motor that's in the Messerschmitt?
It's a similar motor, but it's a different design. It's now got a metal front on it.
Ah, okay.
So a little bit more durable, can handle the power. Just tons of power. Great flying airplane. Obviously, because it's aerobatic, can do just about any aerobatic maneuver. And truthfully, a lot of the guys who got into T-28s loved it because of how aerobatic it was.
Oh yeah.
And so this is kind of for those guys who want that next level, something that actually can do aerobatics a little bit more precisely than say a T-28 could.
Yeah. Okay. And you said 30 amp ESC.
Correct.
How many servos in this one?
This one will have four servos. You have two aileron servos, one rudder, and one elevator servo.
Okay. And, okay, bind and fly and plug and play.
Correct.
That means bind and fly comes with a receiver.
Correct.
Which one?
It will have the AR500 receiver installed. And here's also one of the new features, a very strong magnetic hatch. No worry about that coming off. But have the receiver right here, two servos, battery mounts up in here, really nice and secured, straps down, speed control up in the front, very straightforward.
Really cool installation, nice and clean and everything.
One of the really nice things about this airplane is it's got a two-piece wing.
Oh,
so
yes, I saw that.
Remove two bolts, the wing slides out, it's even easier to transport.
Slides on with a carbon fiber tube.
Correct, yes, does have a carbon tube. Just a very easy airplane to put together. It's got a one-piece stab, just slides through the opening here, tape it in place. I mean, it's very similar to what you've seen from the previous ParkZone airplanes in terms of how to assemble.
Yeah, well, these two-piece wings have become kind of the standard of most of the airplanes, whether it's Hangar 9 or E-flite or ParkZone.
Absolutely.
Because it makes it really easy to transport. Sure, the airplane's not very big, but it makes it really simple to get it into any car without taking up too much space
or on your
long run off to the park there to fly the thing.
It makes it a nice clean way to do a mid-mounted wing on airplanes as well.
So. Now I see in the hatch that it has a pilot.
Correct.
In there is that the way it comes in the package?
Yep, pilot figure is included with the airplane just as you see here.
That's cool. And wheel pans.
Yep.
Now, these are very nice wheel pants. I like the installation method there. That's very cool.
Yeah, basically, the landing gear will slip into the channel on the bottom of the fuselage, and then you just attach these little cover plates to give the illusion of a wheel cover on the landing gear leg, and then just simple wheel covers that screw onto the axle, makes it a very solid, sturdy landing gear.
Okay. Now, I see there that the two aileron servos are just essentially hidden. Covered so they're not exposed or anything.
Correct.
On the bottom. This thing's really got a nice clean appearance.
Yes.
What about this color scheme? Where'd that come from? That's very nice.
This is actually Mike McConville's color scheme. Obviously, the orange contrasting the white is just very bright, and of course you have dramatically different tops and bottoms, so it's very easy to see orientation.
Oh, yeah.
When you're doing, you know, rolling maneuvers or quick maneuvers.
Yeah, okay, well, that's very cool. Spinner, that is part of the kit?
Yep, absolutely, comes with it. Just a nice little plastic spinner, uses a single screw in the front to attach.
Now, let's talk for just a second about the plug-and-play version.
Okay.
What have you got, or what have you not got, I guess, is the question there.
With the plug-and-play, you basically get the airframe. There's no battery, no receiver, no charger, and no transmitter.
Okay.
So if you already have that stuff from previous airplanes, you know, you're not basically buying it again. You know, you can use your existing equipment, is what it's
now,
kind of intended for.
By the way, I've got a DX7 here. For the bind and fly, a DSM2 transmitter like a DX7 would be
correct.
Or DX6i, or
yes,
maybe a JR radio.
We definitely recommend a computer radio on this airplane. Being that it's aerobatic, it allows you to get the most functionality out of the airplane. You can set up dual rates to your taste, set up exponential, things like that, to really fine-tune the way the airplane flies to your preference.
Yeah, travel adjustments,
exactly,
things like that.
Exactly.
Pretty standard on most of the radios these days, other than maybe the very base RTF type transmitters.
Correct.
Or something. But
yes.
I think the people that are flying this airplane have probably been through an airplane or two, and so they probably already have a transmitter. But what pilot is this really designed for? You mentioned that it's basically an aerobatic airplane, so
yeah.
I expect you're looking for a little more skill level than a beginner.
I would say it would be a great airplane for somebody stepping up past a T-28, you know, who's kind of worn out their T-28 and is ready for that next aerobatic level. This will definitely, you know, solve that problem for them and get them really excited.
Somebody that has got some aileron experience,
yes,
and pretty well can handle that, then
yeah, this is definitely a go where you point it airplane. Doesn't have any self-righting tendencies, so you kind of, you know, have to have, you know what you're doing when you're flying it.
So in other words, everybody that's got a T-28 has got to have an extra.
Exactly.
Yeah, I get it. Okay, you guys are ahead of us, but we're going to catch up with you here. Well, Matt, this is really cool. I kind of like to get a hold of one of these myself as soon as they're available. Right now we're towards the end of April. Mm-hmm. When do you expect this to hit the dealer shelves?
We're going to show it the first time at CEF here this weekend coming up, and then it should be basically right about a month before you see it on the dealer shelves.
Okay, so somewhere before the end of May, we should all be flying extra 300s. This is great. Well, guys, get ready. You know, when that thing shows up, I mean, we'll all have to make a report to our Facebook page. The Horizon Facebook page has to keep up to speed with what you guys are doing, and
absolutely,
I want to hear what you got to say about this airplane. So let's be watching for it and get a hold of one right away. This is going to be a lot of fun. I appreciate your coming in, Matt.
Absolutely.
And a lot of good information there. So our viewers are, I'm sure they're going to be all over it. And this is just a good-looking airplane, so great job. Thanks for viewing, and keep your eye out for the new ParkZone Extra 300.